All right, welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Fanon, and in this video we're going to be talking about the 147 pound division where Jeff Mayweather had something to say and Shane Mosley has something to say about Errol Spence Jr. and really where he should go in his career, and also a little bit about Floyd Mayweather Jr. and Errol Spence and the truth behind their sparring, according to Jeff Mayweather. Let's talk about that in this video. All right, welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Fanon. And in this video, we're going to be in the 147 pound division where Jeff Mayweather, the uncle of Floyd Mayweather Jr., had something to say about an infamous sparring session that took place between Floyd and Errol Spence Jr. and what he was reiterating after this fight between Errol and Terrence took place. And he did it in response to questions about how Terrence Crawford and Floyd Mayweather Jr. would match up, which I think is a very, very interesting question for me, because, you know, I know a lot of people don't really like historical matchups and things like that and fantasy matchups, but hey man, that's one of the really good things about boxing, is that you can compare people across different, you know, age ranges, or, you know, fighters from the 90s and the 80s to the ones in the 2000s to the ones in the 2010s and 2020. It's one of the things that really do make boxing interesting. But what Jeff Mayweather said about Floyd and Errol is what really piqued my attention. Now, before I get into that though, let me welcome you back to the channel. If you are new to the channel, please accept my invitation to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon so you can be notified of when we release more videos. And if you are a longtime subscriber and supporter of the channel, thank you so much for your continued support. It really, really does make a huge difference to the channel. And thank you to everybody that supports in the super thanks of videos like this. So, all right, look, gotta say thank you to the sponsor of this video, Boxing Showtime's app. And I want to introduce you to this really great app for really for hardcore boxing fans that want to know everything that's going on in boxing. It's a very accessible app right in your hands that you are able to see all of the upcoming fights, that are around your neighborhood, the ones that are going on at bars near you, boxing updates, boxing news, boxing profiles, tales of the tape, boxing tickets, official highlights, official replays. You got a dark mode if that's how you like to look at your screen, a bar locator, everything that you need to be to allow you the most access possible and information possible for the sport that we love. Also, there's a promotional code that you can use, Fanon Box at Fanon, that will allow you to have access to the premium features of the app, as well as a 14-day trial for the premium features of that app. Very inexpensive monthly fee. So make sure you guys go check that out. Does support the channel. Thank you. Like this. So as we know, Errol Spence Jr. got beat by Terrence Crawford. And now there's a lot of people saying, well, we think Terrence Crawford is the best welterweight of this century, and we think that he can beat Floyd Mayweather Jr. Because, you know, how great a fighter he is. Because he's a great fighter, without a doubt, man. You know, one of the things that kind of bugged me about all of this whole thing with Errol and Terrence and talking about who's going to win the fight is that lost in the shuffle in it is that they were both very, very good fighters, and this was an opportunity for one of them to prove that they're a great fighter, right? So in the lead into it, picking Errol Spence Jr. to win by decision, which is what is my pick, a lot of people, that at least the people of you guys that talk to me, just read the either the title of the video or the thumbnail to the video, really missed it at what I had been trying to impress upon people the entire time, which is that Terrence Crawford is an absolute beast of a fighter, man. And without a doubt, dude is very, 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 very hard to beat for anybody. So the notion that Terrence Crawford could beat Floyd Mayweather Jr., to me, it doesn't seem, it's not crazy to me. I do not think, just if I would say who the better fighter is, I don't think that I would say Terrence. I would say Errol. I would say Floyd. And who's the best, like who really is the best, who's the best fighter at their absolute best? I don't think there's really any question that it's Floyd Mayweather Jr. That boy is just, that man was just other level at 130 pounds. Just, oh my God, crazy good. And then he just went weight division after weight division after weight division, not even being near his top, and was still handling people, you know? Where I think Terrence is coming in, kind of coming into his own a little bit, into his natural weight class, which I believe is 147. But one of the things that came up in this conversation with Jeff Mayweather was what he said, kind of like in an I told you so type of fashion, where he said, look, when we're comparing Terrence and Mayweather, you can't talk about Errol Spence in the sparring session. Because the person was asking a question, and he said, well, you know, one of the things that they're saying is, you know, what happened with Errol Spence in the sparring with Floyd Mayweather when Floyd Mayweather Jr. was preparing for Robert the Ghost. I believe he was preparing for Robert the Ghost Guerrero, you know, the infamous sparring session. And Jeff Mayweather addressed that, and he said, look, man, that's what I've been telling you. You cannot compare Floyd Mayweather Jr. as a fighter to Errol Spence Jr. at all, because Floyd Mayweather Jr. has excellent, excellent defense. His defense is just another level. And he said, look, with that sparring session, look, man, people kind of got all excited about it because Errol kept saying, no, let's keep going, let's keep going. And Floyd was like at the end of having sparred several other people. And then Errol gets in there, gives him some good work. But Floyd was at the end of his sparring session, so he had the right to say, nah, I'm okay. Thank you, I'm done. And so a lot of people put out, you know, really talked about the really good work that Errol did. Now, obviously, Errol also came in to the professionals and did a lot of really good work as the professional at 147 pounds as well. So it's not like it was like he just did that and he didn't back it up. But at the same time, I do think it's safe to say, you know, that the top fighter really is, you know, of the two is Floyd Mayweather. Which is no insult whatsoever to Floyd Mayweather, to Errol Spence Jr. Because, I mean, short of somebody like Sugar Ray Robinson, I mean, I'm not quite sure who people would say is better in that weight class or in a pound-for-pound setting. Even though I will tell you there are welterweights that I would have picked to beat Floyd at welterweight, namely two of them in the 80s, which is Sugar Ray Leonard and Thomas the Hitman Hearns. And I'm taking Sugar Ray Leonard over Terrence Crawford, and I'm taking Tommy Hearns over Terrence Crawford too. Those dudes right there were very big welterweights who started off in the welterweight division, and both have concussive power, very fast hands, very fundamentally sound. And I don't know, you know, if we've seen a fight with two better welterweights, or a time when there were two better welterweights in a division, other than maybe if you go back, you know, to where we'll really be a judge of it and talk about, you know, like the Charlie Burley Murderers Row time, around that, you know, when those black welterweights and middleweights had to all fight each other because people wouldn't fight them, and which is really like during one of the major heydays in boxing. But yeah, I would take those guys over Terrence Crawford and Floyd Mayweather Jr. But as far as like what Jeff Mayweather said about not taking that too far, taking what happened in the sparring between the two of them too far, I think that's probably accurate and probably something going forward that people will take into consideration. Also, you know, that comes into play with a lot of other stuff that people talk about with sparring. And people beating up people in sparring and what they're doing in sparring. Like, people were putting a lot of weight on Brian Norman Jr. supposedly having dropped Terrence Crawford in sparring. Well, that didn't really show anything or really have any effect on the fight that took place with Errol Spence on Saturday. You know, on Saturday. And although I'm sure that there's things in Errol Spence Jr.'s camp that may have affected his performance, and just generally the fact that he probably shouldn't be in that weight class anymore. Still, there could be things going on in Terrence Crawford's camp as well that could definitely, you know, have affected him. But anyway, I just thought it was a really good, interesting conversation from Jeff Mayweather talking about Errol Spence Jr. in that particular sparring session with Floyd Mayweather Jr. and what he thought about this whole Floyd and Terrence thing. But anyway, that's my take on the matter. You let me know what you think in the comment section. And with that, I'm out. Peace.